Today we're going to create a barbed wire type style. To do that, we'll need to make a pattern brush. So I've downloaded a barbed wire photo to have as a reference. I'm in Illustrator and I've placed this photograph here. I will lock it by pressing Command 2. Now I'll take my pen tool, have a gray stroke, and I'm trying to design a basic pattern of my brush. A little bit bigger stroke, window, stroke, okay, around it. Now, I will draw my path. And my second one. Now, this one. This one. This one. This one, this one, this one, and this one. Perhaps the stroke is too big. Window, stroke. Maybe this is okay. Okay. Now I'm going to expand this stroke. I will select all of it. Object, expand. Now, as you can see, by pressing Command Y, my stroke is now a shape. Now, I want to make this a little bit more edgier. So, I will take my direct selection tool, go here, select this anchor, and the same thing here. And here, click, click. Here, here, and here. Now I will unlock Command Alt 2, my photograph, and delete it. I don't need it anymore. Now, to create this type of pattern, I need three things. First of all, I want the inner section of the pattern, which will be around this thing, I believe, and the outer, this and this. Now, I will bring my rulers, Command R, inside my area. And I say I want it here and here. Now, because when the pattern will be repeated, I want these points to be joined exactly. So I need to bring my rulers here and match it with the other side. So I take again my direct selection tool. I'll bring everything a little bit here. And I will take these edges and do that thing here. Take the edges. And this edge here. up to edges. I need to join them. Command J. And I think this is okay. Now, I will create a rectangle that snaps this side and this side. I will need two more rectangles. One here, press Command Y, and one on the other side. Now, I don't want any fill or stroke on these rectangles. So I will remove it. So now, let's expand our artboard a little bit. I will duplicate this three times. I select it all, press, and by dragging copy, and pressing Shift and Alt, I duplicate it. Now I press Command D to do exactly the same. Let's expand the artboard a little bit. Now, I will erase this, this, and this. I will group, or should have done this better, Command G. Command G and Command G. And now I'll select this one, go to my Pathfinder and select crop. This crop and this crop. Now I'll take this thing here and drop it, drag and drop it on my swatch panel. This one again here, this one again here. Now I hope this is okay. Now I go to my brushes panel and click new brush, new pattern brush. Side is this one. And that's it. Now let's do it again. Create a new brush, pattern brush, and we have the side will be this one. The start tile will be this one, I think. And the end will be this one. So if I go here and create a line, apply my brush, I should have this one. Now, because I haven't created corners, you see, this cannot work. But if I am pretty straightforward, this is pretty okay. You see, I have my wire here. Now, let's create some typography with this barbed wire pattern. Now, I will type the word free, just a random font. I'll press Command Shift 2 to create outline it and Command 5 to make it guide. Now, I'll take again my pen tool. I'll choose a stroke, and I will create a stroke inside of these letters. So I'll do one. Remember, I haven't created any corners, so I won't if I have a corner, I will try to make it curvy. write a word free. My is now. Let's fill it with our new pattern. As you can see, I have a mess here. That's because I created my stroke in a very big scale. If I make my stroke a little bit smaller, for example 0.2, perhaps 3, my type is ready. Now let's create a background for this. I have opened in a new document this splash image. I go to image trace and I go to high fidelity photo and trace it. Now I go to object, expand. Okay. I select it and divide it from the pathfinder, divide, and command shift G. Now I take my direct selection tool, select the white, go to select, same fill color, and delete all the whites. Now I take it again and fill it with the color and group it, command G. Copy it, command C, and paste it to this document. Now, oops, let's expand this object, expand. Select same fill color and delete these things. And now I have this. Let's do it a little bit darker. Let's say 80%. Now I think my background like it to be a little bit red. Here, or perhaps this is okay. Command 2, and now I will make this splash appear from the back. I select the background color. Window transparency multiply. Let's see what this is going to do. Let's make it a little bigger. Now let's copy the background, command C, command F, paste in place, bring it to front, command shift right bracket, select both and make it a mask, command 7. Now select this, command back, and I think this is okay for now. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.